We want to find the first seven terms of the sequence given the recursive formula a sub n equals a sub n minus 1 plus a sub n minus 2. This is called a recursive formula because a sub n is based upon previous terms in the sequence. And since a sub n is based upon previous terms, when given a recursive formula, notice we're also given a sub 1 and a sub 2, or the first two terms in the sequence. So if we want to find the first seven terms, we need to find a sub 1 through a sub 7. But again, notice how we were already given the first two terms. So the first term is 1, and the second term is also 1. And now if we want to find a sub 3 of the third term, notice that's telling us that n is equal to 3. So we'll substitute 3 here and here, which means a sub 3 is equal to a sub 3 minus 1, that's 2, or a sub 2, plus a sub 3 minus 2, which is positive 1. So notice the third term is the sum of the second term and the first term, which are both 1. So the third term is 2. Now to find a sub 4, n is equal to 4. So we'd have a sub 4 minus 1, that's 3, plus a sub 4 minus 2 is 2. So notice how the fourth term is the sum of the third term and second term. So we'd have 2 plus 1, which is equal to positive 3. To find the fifth term, n is equal to 5. So we'd have a sub 5 minus 1 is 4, plus a sub 5 minus 2 is 3. So the fifth term is the sum of the fourth and third term. So we have 3 plus 2, which is equal to 5. So hopefully you're beginning to see the pattern. In order to find the sixth term, we would have the sum of the fifth term and the fourth term, or the two previous terms before the sixth term. So we'd have 5 plus 3, which is equal to 8. If I lost you there, of course we can just substitute 6 for n. This would give us a sub 5. This would give us a sub 4. And then finally for the seventh term, n is equal to 7. So we would have a sub 6 plus a sub 5. Again, the two previous terms before the seventh term. So we'd have 8 plus 5, which is equal to 13. Let's go ahead and make this into a list. So we have 1, comma 1, comma 2, comma 3, 5, 8, 13. Now that we have a list, if we want the next term, we would just add 13 and 8. That would give us 21. The next term would be 21 plus 13. That would be 34, and so on. This is actually one of the most famous sequences that you'll find. This is called the Fibonacci sequence. One of the reasons that it's so famous is these numbers appear in nature quite often. So for example, if we take a look at some flowers and count the number of petals on the flowers, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, notice 8 does appear in the Fibonacci sequence. And for one more example, notice how this flower has 5 petals. And 5 is a Fibonacci number. And the number of spirals in such things as cauliflower, pineapples, and in this case a pine cone, notice how if we count the spirals already marked here in both directions, there are 8 red spirals and 13 blue spirals, which again are both Fibonacci numbers. And another reason why this sequence is so famous is if we use the Fibonacci numbers to create squares, as we see here on the left, we can use these squares to approximate the golden spiral, as we see here, which is a very famous spiral based upon the golden ratio. So if you're interested, I would highly encourage you to do a search on the Fibonacci sequence to explore this sequence in more detail. I hope you found this example helpful.